Dr. Loretta Bolgan, hello, welcome to Slovenia. You had a very interesting lecture today about your investigation of the quality of vaccines. So, if you can make it shorter right now, what were your findings about the quality of vaccines?
Yes, we analyzed, we did a quality investigations of four vaccines. Three of them they are authorized at the European level, the Imperix X, Xion, there are two equivalent vaccines, and Gardasil 9, the antipapilloma virus vaccine, and the Priorix Tetra, that is a national authorized vaccine from Germany, the measles, mumps, rubella, and varicella vaccine. The results that we found, if we needed to say in one word, we can say that all four vaccines are defective. They're defective for chemical contaminations, for genetic material contaminations, different from one vaccine to the other one. Because let's say that for the protein vaccines like Imperix X and Xion, the major problem were the chemical contaminations, that we found plenty of candidate compounds, toxic also. And another thing that it was a major concern, it was the characteristic of the antigens bound to aluminum. When aluminum binds to the antigens, it changes the conformation of the antigens. They give a particular property that we can say right now, we can hypothesize that, we can't yet confirm this. It's a prionic-like behavior that could have also a safety issue, safety concern. Since these macromolecules that are inside of the vaccines are unsolvable and undigestible, they have also an efficacy problems, and this needs to be studied much more, because if we couldn't digest the antigens to analyze them, also in vivo, the immune system can't recognize them and produce antibodies that are protective for the six diseases. Priorix Tetra instead had a major problem regarding the presence of genetic material. In particular, we found the whole genome from MRC5 cell line used for the production of varicella and mumps attenuated viruses. This DNA from studies coming from other groups, like the one of Dr. Deschen, proved to be carcinogenic. It means that has the property to integrate in the genome of the host. So we did the whole genome sequencing of this cell line, the one inside the vaccine, and we found that is highly modified from the point of from the genetic point of view. We found a lot of translocation on oncogenes, so this DNA is potentially cancerogenic and makes the vaccine really potentially dangerous. We can say also that the amount is really relevant, in a meaning that we can say that the Priorix Tetra is not mumps, rubella, varicella, and measles vaccine, but it's a fit DNA vaccine. So this is very important to underline. Gardasil 9 is it's a DNA recombinant technology vaccine, and he has major problems regarding the chemical contaminants. the presence also of cancerogenic viruses that do the contamination of the vaccine. And plus we have contamination from the papilloma virus fragments that are called L1, and that we confirm the presence. And we know from the research from Professor B that this kind of fragments, when they bind, when they bind to aluminum, they get stabilized, and they can cause damages in the place where they are translocated in the body, and they could be at risk of a serious adverse event. Pretty much, I would say that all the vaccines have some particular problems that the regulatory agency needs to take care.
So you mentioned that some toxicological studies are missing and etc. So are vaccines studied enough to claim that they are safe enough to use them?
No, we are completely missing the toxicological studies on injected vaccines on the pediatric population, because we don't have the data of toxicology of vaccines on the babies, because like in my answer, the safety data come from clinical studies, but clinical studies normally they're made to study efficacy, and the safety actually is studied only for a short time, and there you can see only acute adverse event. You don't have any information on the long-term toxicity, and the toxicological studies on the particular kind of contaminations that are inside the vaccines, they have data only on ingested toxicity. We don't have any information on injectable toxicity.
And it's also, you mentioned that vaccines are biological products, so they cannot be standardized. But how do we control them? So that means that actually the quality is also probably different from vaccine to vaccine.
Yes, that's what we found out. It means that there is a huge difference in terms of contaminations from one lot to the other one for the same vaccines. There are huge differences between one vaccine of a particular pharmaceutical company and other vaccines, the same kind of vaccines, but of other pharmaceutical companies. So this is a particular characteristic of biological products when they're made by cell lines. And it's very difficult to standardize them. And they say that to produce a high quality vaccine, it's essential that the raw materials are very high quality. So they need to be purified very much, deep purification, because of what is inside the raw material, in particular the combined vaccination, like the 6-in-1 or Gardasil 9 that is made of 9 different antigens, they carry all the contamination from the raw material, plus they add new contamination from the manufacturing process. So, and this has a cumulative, they become like a cumulative amount of contaminants. And we don't know, it becomes unpredictable toxicity when they are all together. Because the effect on toxicity is not cumulative, they could synergize between them. And this can be very different from one lot to the other one.
So right now, as far as I understand, there is no control about the vaccines.
I mean, there is a control. There is, of course, the manufacturing processes control for certain targets. What we did, we applied the technology, the control that is made during the research and development of the vaccine, we applied it to the final product. Because you need to consider that when you develop a new vaccine, you needed to do a screening of all the contaminants that are inside. From the contaminants, you select the one that you consider more dangerous for the health, and you control only that contaminant. That's what the manufacturer do until the batch release of the vaccine on the market. The problem is that since the toxicology of the vaccine is based on ingested specifications, the contaminations that we found are not controlled. So what is necessary to do is to modify the specification considering that we are talking about an injectable vaccine, an injectable drug, and to control with this new technology that they're very accurate finding contamination, chemicals and genetic material.
As a consumers, we would need to demand to see if the vaccine is actually purified. Otherwise, it can be obviously full of contaminations.
Yeah, it's very important to improve, at least, like I said at the beginning, we can say that these four vaccines have major problems of quality and they are defective because they are injectable drugs. And maybe the regulatory agency can say that the contamination that we found are not an issue for the health, but they are not an issue for the health, maybe if they are ingested, but they become serious contamination when they are injected. And this, it means that it's necessary for sure to improve the quality of the purification of the vaccine, or for them, in particular the raw material.